And my gambling addiction basically you put an end to my profession.
Jeffrey is happy to share his own story if it means helping others. He works with the Delaware Council on Gambling Problems, and he's part of a two-day conference discussing the alarming rise in gambling during the pandemic, so much of it online. He says more younger people are experiencing gambling problems, and technology is a huge enabler.
People who used to have to find a way to sneak out to get to a casino can now feed their addiction wherever they are. I mean, I just kind of pulled into a parking lot right here. You grab your phone and you're ready to play some bets. It's now much harder for your family even to detect that you might have a problem.
Jeffrey says there are two kinds of problem gamblers, the ones who get addicted to the rush of the bet, and then there are those using gambling like some people use drugs or alcohol as a way to zone out and numb themselves to their own deeper issues. And this isn't just about online casino games. March Madness takes on a whole new meaning for problem gamblers. They might bet on video games too, and all this talk about the GameStop stock story and easy investing apps like Robinhood, well, that's gambling too, and it can all make some people's problems get worse.
All of these, quote, new age forms of gambling create their own separate problem, but it's the same old consequences. It's the harm financially, emotionally, and in every aspect of your life.
Gambling might seem like an answer to the extra boredom and loneliness of the pandemic, but the problems might linger once the world opens back up. Here's some good news, though. As much as we all have grown to despise virtual meetings, Jeffrey says they have actually made it easier for people with gambling problems to get almost instant help when they feel themselves falling back into their habit. He hopes you get help if you think you have a gambling addiction.
Now we reach out to others and we talk about it, and we remind ourselves what gambling has done to us in the past, and that if we go back, what we know it's going to do to us in the present.
Tim Furlong, NBC 10 News.